After leaving the kitchen and that cock-hogging blonde, I walked out onto the back lawn of the mansion. The cool night air counterbalanced the heat made by the clusterfuck of naked bodies spread out on the grass. The sexual moans of randy women and the hungry gnarls of horny men were inviting to me, like music to my ears. And although I was excited that I felt my pulse beating through my pussy lips after the screw in the kitchen, considering it was my first encounter of the night, it seemed to pale in comparison to the sandwich fuck going strong not too far from the jacuzzi. There were two guys with a chicken between them. She donned a strap-on and was fucking the guy in front of her in the ass. My pussy started vibrating. I mean, it was like I'd hit orgy heaven. Off to the side was a cardboard box filled with dildos, vibrators, and strap-ons. Like a kid on Christmas morning, I eagerly picked out a black strap-on. It looked about 9 inches long and was thick. Never hesitating, I jumped at the front of the sandwich fuck, became the head of the train. The guy behind me softly touched my shoulder and told me that his name is Hannibal. Seemed like an awkward name, but then I figured, who gives out their real names at these types of functions? I could be anybody I damn well pleased. I laid on my side and said over my shoulder, "I'm Ivana. Ivana Fuckalot." He gave me a smile, letting me know that he caught the joke and that he was satisfied with what I told him. He looked like he was in his mid-30s, and the crow's feet around his eyes gave him a sophisticated attraction. He swept his thick tongue across my lips while stroking himself slowly, and I thought to myself, "By gum, I've met a gentleman." I turned around, lifted my leg in the air, and let Hannibal slip his cock in my ass. It wasn't easy for him at first. I was tight, but he added pressure, causing my hole to wrap around his head with a snap. It was a little painful because I hadn't been fucked that way in a while, but when he grabbed a mini bottle of lube and rubbed it on his shaft and my asshole, the pleasure outweighed the pain as his cock sank deep. I let him repeatedly glide in and out of me, sharing the flow, the rhythm of the other three bodies behind me as we all became one. I melted in the sounds of moans and dirty words surrounding me. The excitement of people crying out, urging on the eruption of orgasmic pleasure, and oh fuck yeah here, and oh shit there, made my pussy tingle and butterflies dance around in my stomach. Hannibal lifted my leg a little higher, spreading my cheeks and hole more. I relaxed and let him do most of the work. I surrendered. Then I looked over at the jacuzzi and noticed a familiar face and unfamiliar plump breasts submerged in the bubbling jacuzzi water. It was my friend Karen. I wasn't sure if she'd agree or not, but fumbling with the strap on, I put it on anyway. Never stopping or slowing down Hannibal as he sped up the motion of his hips, his thighs slapped my ass cheeks louder and faster with each plunge of his hard piece. Looking hungrily at Karen, I'd hoped her pussy was ready because I was going to show her a side of me that she had never seen or felt before. I'd prepare to call out her name, but figured it an injustice to her if Hannibal and I were using aliases. Plus, it was difficult to call out anything besides a wail of painful ecstasy. Hannibal was flowing in and out of my ass with heavy thrusts. His sweat dripped, sticky skin slapping against mine, but I kept my eyes on Karen, who'd gotten out of the jacuzzi. I must admit, I feared she'd walk back into the mansion before I had a chance to share this wonderful experience, and I gathered all the strength I needed to call her by her nickname. "Honey Bunny," I yelled, exasperatedly. She turned in my direction, and boy did her eyes grow wide as silver dollars. The shock of seeing me at the front of the sandwich fuck momentarily paralyzed her. She was also shocked by the guy who snuck up behind her. He gently put his hands on either side of her waist, but she only flinched. Actually, the guy looked familiar to me as well. I stared harder, and then it hit me. I'm like, that's Karen's fuck buddy, Mr. Johnson Dickinson, or John D for short. He sat back on the lush grass, pulling her down onto his lap. Lying back, she straddled him without hesitation, and let his dick slide up into her pretty pussy. She threw her head back, her mouth opened, and started tweaking her nipples with the fingertips as her body and breasts bounced up and down. John's dick was like the holy grail of cocks. It was so damn thick and had to stretch 10 inches at least. I couldn't understand why in the hell that motherfucker wasn't ringing her bells in the bedroom. And suddenly, a part of me wanted to find out, to sample it. I turned around, the cock still pumping in and out of my ass, the strap-on bouncing around wildly in front of me, and kissed Hannibal. I let his tongue explore every section of my mouth as I took glances in Karen's direction to make sure she saw me. I wanted her to see me and invite me over. I wanted to try out the dick that made her face grimace in both pain and pleasure. Karen's legs must have gotten tired, so she rolled her body over onto her side, and John rolled right with her, never missing a beat. His thick cock stayed deep inside her tight cunt, never slipping out, never missing a beat, making long, deep strokes inside of her. The way the muscles in his ass flexed with each push turned me on even more. I couldn't resist. My covetous nature arose like a phoenix from its own ashes. My desire was too strong to suppress any longer. Doing just what I'd done to the guy in the kitchen, I clenched my asshole, which at first must have given Hannibal a rush of pleasure, then pain. He pulled out of me, making that popping sound, and his heavy cock fell on my ass like a slain snake. He reached around me, his fingers groping my breasts, and slid his hand back and forth across my nipples, sending shivers throughout my chest. I stood up, the muscles in my ass throbbing, my pussy pulsing, and my legs weak. I was ready to move on to John. He was my conquest, the must-have dick of the night. When I approached Karen and John, there was instantly a fire in her eyes. It seemed, at first, an eagerness to bond, and at the same time, a fierceness I couldn't quite place. She turned the corner of her mouth up in a smile, one eyebrow arched, looking seductive. Without saying a word, she reached out for me and pulled me down onto the lawn in front of her. The strap-on lay lifeless on the grass as she and I faced each other, and then she palmed it in a tight grip, looking me in the eyes and speaking to me through her actions. Scooting closer to me, she reached for a nearby bottle of lube and soaked up the fake cock enough to enter her tunnel with ease. I was slightly hesitant because John's big dong was still inside her pussy, but she gripped the tip of the dildo and positioned it at the opening of her stretched pussy lips, slowly helping me guide it inside of her. The dildo oozed into her slowly as John's cock rushed back and forth, the friction making my pussy tingle and itch for a taste. Warm juices rushed from her as her pussy slurped in both his cock and the strap-on. She quivered, grit her teeth, and nodded for me to continue, so I pushed the dildo deeper inside her. The black tulle so motionless compared to John's cream-colored strokes. He moaned when I pulled the dildo out of her and slowly slid it back into her moist pussy lips. She wrapped her arms around my shoulders and buried her face in my neck as John snuggled closer to her, her right leg high in the air. Between her panting and gasps, Karen whispered that she couldn't believe this was happening. She made sounds like she was crying, but the smile on her face told otherwise. Her reddening face had a rosy glow, and I knew she was in a state of euphoria. As I pumped my hips back and forth, setting Karen's pussy aflame, I couldn't help wishing that John was inside me. I imagined that the dildo strapped to my body was his cock, and that Karen's pussy was mine. I saw my slit fold in with each sinking motion of his fat cock and fell into a hypnotizing trance, her pleasure becoming my pleasure. Karen's breath beat against my neck, the warmth heating my body, it seemed. Her brown hair cascaded down and across her neck, and it smelled like peppermint and lavender. And while it felt wonderful to provide her with the pleasure she now received, I wanted more than anything to be in her position. She lifted her head, her brown eyes striking mine, stopping everything but the motion of our hips, back and forth, with hypnotic ease. Our bodies humped and swayed together, on and on as she stared into my eyes, her breath now beating against my upper lip. Then her face shifted. Something had changed in a matter of seconds. The rhythm we'd developed stopped as I now pumped her motionless body. Her eyes darted away from mine and behind me, but I was too engulfed in the fantasy I'd become lost in. The intimacy I'd felt was stronger and sexier than anything I'd ever experienced, and my cunt hadn't been touched at all. Then, when my leg was slowly lifted by an unexpected hand, I understood why she disconnected from me. I lifted onto my elbow to glance behind Karen, the dildo still inside her. And John wasn't behind her anymore. He'd had enough of her pussy and was now behind me, undoing the strap-on and stroking a hand covered in lube across my beating pussy, preparing to let me sample his package.